Ours is a party of women, by and large. And yet no two of us are the same.
Avoid flame at any cost, Arisa. You have been doused in oil.
Might we remove this hindrance somehow? If a ranged attack is needed.
Their master, Sorius! I shan't allow any further harm to come to you. I grant your weapon a magical boon. I'll collect that. You needn't trouble yourself. Let us aim for greater precision with our next attempt. Common reward.
Frustratingly so.
We cannot expect gleaming treasures around every corner.
This heavy pack is slowing me down somewhat, but methinks I can manage for the time being.
Go and open the chest. Might I be of assistance? I shall not fail you. There, Master! To match your skill, Master. I merely do as duty demands. Say it. We trounced our foe well and true. Overconfidence is an enemy in and of itself. Let us instead strive to better ourselves with every battle.
This place offers a view of the sea. I imagine we would not escape a plunge into the water's depths.
Seems they bear us ill will.
Just recalled, I found a treasure chest near here during my travels beyond the rift. May I show you to its location?
I did not fall to prowess.
I can do no better service to the risen.
Well said. The fire must be put out ere our comrade burns.
I shall heal you at once. Wait a moment.
Turn out your pockets.
Oi, hand over all the coin in your purse now.
Who's there?
Who's there?
I grant your weapon a magical boost. Remain calm, else all will be lost. I'll pick that up. We might have need of it. Skeletons there! We ought to extinguish our lanterns, lest we summon it unwittingly. Mayhap you will think this a trifle, but one master I served was quite the carefree sort, shunning armor in all its forms. Each to their own.
This looks as if it will take us someplace further afield. How we use it is at our discretion.
I dare say there'd be no harm in using this.
Is radiant, isn't it? I feel at peace to gaze upon it. True enough. magics you bestowed have failed.
A little something, won't you? Many thanks, sir.
Are we to remain here?
Ah, a ballista. These have quite a long range. This could grant us an edge in battle, if we use it well.
Is a mechanism for hauling freight, and it looks as if it could bear a significant load. Might we not avail ourselves of its use?
We pawns cannot set foot in Batal without feeling the people's contempt for us.
Take heart, for we are fulfilling our duty at the Arisen's side. We have naught to be ashamed of.
No need for restraint when you're with me, Kaz.
I need a favor, Kaz. Feeling generous?
Appreciate you, Kaz.
present surroundings make for clear.
I'll pack myself up on the talk around.
Go.
This is most convenient. Another destination we were bound for is not far from here. Efficiency is not the only factor worthy of consideration. Come, I'll lead the way. Here we are. We shall remain here.
What do you want? You've got the Empress. This some kind of jape? Suppose the fact you're telling this to me means you're in the know. You one of us? Right then, I'll pass these tidings along to our interested party. Where should I tell them to find you? The empty house south of the Pilgrim's Path, is it? Fair enough. Fear not. I'll arrange for the interested party to meet you in the empty house south of the Pilgrim's Path.
I have been waiting for you, Arisen. Allow me to lead the way. I can take you to our destination by the optimum route.
Sir Arisen, I take it you have given the Coral Snakes the information we discussed. Then the villain behind Her Majesty's assassination will doubtless be compelled to act with all due haste. And so must we. Let us begin our preparations presently.
Our preparations are complete. Shall we make for the empty house in Bak-Batal? Pray, allow me to show you the way. You have our gratitude. Lead the way.
It is not long till daybreak, Master.
The sun will always rise again. It is a comforting thought.
Four harpies, Master!
One might confidently call that Arisen. I knew that I could count upon your strength, Arisen. Pray, follow me. Over here, Master. Did you lose sight of me? We have arrived.
Might I implore you to play the part of a bandit, Sir Arisen? As one of Her Majesty's champions, my face is like as not to be known to our villain. I have also employed the aid of a woman resembling Her Majesty in stature and build. She will fulfill the role of Empress during the exchange.
No, Manella. We must go ourselves.
Your Majesty, I don't think...
Should the ruse be discovered too soon, the renegade may flee and escape justice. We must confront them, so that our land and its people may ne'er endure such uncertainty again.
Understood. Then I shall guard your majesty with my life. We must needs be ready for whate'er comes, Sir Arisen.
So, a bit of trickery is in order. Rest assured, Master, that we pawns shall be watching over you all the while. Indeed, you are correct.
I suspect the villain will approach under cover of night. Are your preparations concluded? I am glad to hear it, and not a moment too soon. We have received word that someone approaches our location. Find a way to loosen the villain's tongue. I shall remain hidden till the opportune moment presents itself. May all go as planned.
I am come. Would you kindly open the door?
Thank you.
Let us not waste time. I am here to confirm the identity of your captive and naught else. Where might she be? Let us not waste time. I am here to confirm the identity of your... Indeed. Tis the Empress and none other. Fortunately for you. Had it been anyone else, your head would now be free of its shoulders. Tis by the Coral Snakes' failure that she yet lives. I trust you are prepared to rectify this mistake. Go on. Kill her. How dare you!
Sir Ermild! So 'twas you!
Manella, this little ruse was your doing, I suppose.
In part. But let us continue this discussion in the interrogation room. I want it all on record.
Indeed. Ermild, though it pains us, we must place you under arrest.
You'll do no such thing. I bid you both farewell.
No! Stop her! Forgive me, Your Majesty. She is gone.
Ermild, why?
Silenced by her own hand.
I fear our carelessness has allowed the villain to escape her due judgment. It is a most unfortunate turn of events.
What could have possessed her to do such a thing? I suppose we'll ne'er know now. A pity.
'Tis dark enough to warrant the use of your lantern, Master.
Oh, Ermild.
I'll collect that. You needn't trouble yourself.
When their skulls are smashed beyond repair.
Boxcarts are reliable, if naught else. They are capable allies on journeys near and far.
Let's be on my guard. brained buffoon! Where have you been?
Brucker! Sorry,
There's no time for apologies, girl. We've got to get that blade on the anvil, lest the Blazehammer's treatment be for naught. You're the first apprentice of mine with the gumption to do aught like this. You got the Blazehammer work done, and you did it right. But the hardest part's what comes next. I'll walk you through what's needed. Though I dare say, it is one of the few lessons I've left to teach you. You've proven yourself this day, Sarah. You're the one fit to carry on my techniques and this smithy. But not if you're gonna stand there and gawk. To the forge with you, girl!
Come in, Brucker.
Hi, Arisen. I've been waiting for you. Here it is. Your Regalius sword. Looks newly forged, doesn't it, eh? Brucker had me working on it for hours. Got nary a wink of sleep. But owing to that, methinks it turned out real fine. I only hope you're pleased with it. Tis as much your success as mine. So much has changed for me since you first brought that sword to the smithy. I feel as if I'm finally on the path to becoming a blacksmith in my own right. Thank you, sir, for all you've done on my behalf.
No need to overthink it. You can change it on a whim. You've naught to lose. And you might even make a new discovery.
Pleasure doing business.
Look as long as you please.
This might be worth a read. Shall we take a closer look?
Song, it's
peruse at your leisure, sir.